Alright, hello again. So yesterday I made my first blog entry and then I was like, okay, I'm in Tokyo, what should I do? None of the friends that I'm going to be hanging with this week are here yet, so I was like, you know, might as well not waste the day, you know. Go have a little adventure. First things first, Harajuku.
She said, love me better, kiss me back.
Harajuku is a district in Tokyo that's known for its very, very eccentric fashion styles. Like all the strange fashions you've ever heard about from Japan, that's where they're represented mostly, as well as just like more clothing stores than you could count.
Two hands hold each other. That feels different from when your hands are in mine. That's just the way it is.
And so I was like, all right, Harajuku, here we go. So I get there, first things first, before I see any kind of just like fashion related entity at all, I see this crepe shop and I'm like, hell yeah, crepes. Dude, crepes are the best. So then I go over, I get a crepe.
I got the Miss Marion, because I'm a classy gal.
And then after I've eaten it, I was like, alright, that was an amazing crepe. I mean, that's what I expected. You can't really mess up a crepe. Crepes are perfected, alright, you know. But then, not 4 feet in front of that crepe shop, there's another crepe shop. And I'm just a little confused, like, alright, a little friendly competition. Okay, that makes sense. A little pointless, because crepes are kind of, you can't perfect perfection. I mean, if you're going to have a competitive store, you're going to have to find ways to outsell your rivals, but since there's nowhere else to go with crepes because they are perfect, I mean, it's basically, you're in crepe limbo. So I continue along, Harajuku. There's like 5 more crepe shops. Alright. So anyway, crepes aside, I saw a lot of really cool fashion there, a lot of really strange fashion too, such as women dressed as babies. However, it did seem like most of the fashion there was focused on women, so I tried pretty hard, you know, look for some stores that are more up my alley.
Oh, too cool for school, that's right up my alley. Never mind.
But yeah, that didn't work out, so I was like, okay, Shibuya Crossing, you know, everyone has seen it. It's the place in Tokyo where really millions of people walk a day, the big square. It's like, I'm gonna go there. Shibuya Crossing and the surrounding areas, kind of how I feel like moths feel when they see a lantern at night. Ooh, that's shiny. I want to go to that. Hey, that's shiny too. Whoa, that's shiny. Oh dear. Oh, what is that? Oh, it's so tantalizing. It's so tantalizing. And being alone in such a giant crowd like that definitely enhances the experience. And as I walked around with all the magnificent sights to see, tried some ramen, delicious. Tried some sushi, delicious. Obviously I have to try those two things. Those are the the Japanese staples. Okonomiyaki had some of that. If you don't know what that is like, they make a pancake out of, like, cabbage and bacon, and the ingredients kind of differ depending on what part of Japan you're in, but they put this amazing, amazing sauce on it every time. It's too good. But as I continued to explore this place, I noticed it's not near as clean as the rest of Japan, in multiple ways. There was a crap load of garbage everywhere! Wait, what was that last part again? I think I just fell in love with a porn star. But yeah, I'd have to say my little alone excursion throughout the city was pretty successful. I had a good time, and I'm probably gonna visit those locations again, so as always, stay tuned. This has been Afro Nihongo. Yeah, have you lost your mind? Tell me what you think when you cross the line. No more drugs for me. Pussy and religion is all I